In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. He created man and woman in his image, and that's why you have worth. You're not a product of evolution. You're not a product of random chance. God created you with a purpose. You are a product of his plan. You are not an accident. Don't ever believe it if someone tells you that, because the same God who created time, space, and matter created you with a purpose, and that's why all lives matter. The Bible says that even the hairs on your head are numbered. He knows when you're satisfied and when you hunger. He can hear your deepest thoughts. He can see your wildest dreams. But he also knows what you're watching on that laptop screen. He can see the hate in your heart and the lust in your eyes. He knows everything you've ever stolen and the truth, all your lies. That's why he sent his son Jesus, and that's why Jesus died. Accept him as your Lord and Savior. You'll be righteous in his eyes. You'll be justified. You'll be sanctified because of his sacrifice. He came so that you may have life and live it to the full. So don't let anyone take that away. Not someone from the past or the future or anyone today. Don't let anyone contradict what God has to say, because he says that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. When did this biblical principle become so political? We can't even pass a bill to protect little children. 61 million abortions since Roe versus Wade, and that's not worldwide, that's just in the United States. We're talking about babies who never opened their eyes, whose lives were ended under medications and knives. We've got politicians endorsing late-term abortions and infanticide. God, I don't understand. Can you please tell me why? We've taken the truth of your word and we've tossed it aside and picked up an ideology based on a body of lies that says it's just a bundle of cells. It's not a body alive. I don't understand how anyone can view a fetus like that. It's not a matter of opinion, it's a matter of fact. From the moment of conception, that baby has unique DNA, eye color, hair color, gender, all decided that day. So search your heart and consider if abortion at any stage of gestation is actually okay. Now, if you've ever had an abortion and you're contemplating this decision, I pray that I still have your attention. I want to encourage you to find a church with someone who will sit down and listen, who will give you resources, hope, and a vision. And to remind you that if you have a relationship with Jesus, there's nothing you can do that hasn't already been forgiven, because God sent his son to this earth to fulfill a mission. And when he died on a cross, he said, "It is finished."